meditation is very important. Genesis 24 verse 63. And Isaac went to meditate in the field at the eventide. And he lifted up his eyes and saw, and behold, the camels were coming. No wonder by chapter 26, the man is a billionaire. Why? Because of meditation. The Bible says he went away in the field. That's what separation. Through desire, a man, having separated himself, he seeketh an intermediate with all wisdom. When you meditate on things, vision comes in. You begin to see what is not there physically. Where you open a door for imaginations, imagining the impossible, seeing what others cannot see through the eyes of your mind. When you begin to meditate, you lift your eyes. You begin to project yourself into the future. You see tomorrow today. Check if the decisions you took, you had enough time to meditate through them. You realize that there was no time to meditate and think through matters and issues of life. And what happened? You entered into trouble. Have you handled something above your mind that when it's in the hands, you don't think? Until when you use it up, okay, and come to your level, you know, that's when now you begin to think of the most important things. So the moment the prodigal son got everything, his thinking stopped, because the things were above his capacity, his level. So he went in a far country, and when he spent everything and came to zero, that's when he began to use his mind. And when he began to think, his life turned around. So you must understand, who gave you the mind? Who gave me the mind? It's God. So God wants us to apply the mind, to use the mind, to think. Whatever you don't meditate, you can't do. In the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, there's this book of the law, thou shalt meditate in this book. Why? So that you may observe to do. After you think, you go into doing. But if you don't think, you will not do. That's why you write down resolutions in January 2019. But until now, you have not done one of those things. Because you just wrote them, you never thought through them. You see, if you don't meditate on your relationship, you can't marry. Because if you don't meditate, you are going to continue to harbor people in your life that you don't need. When you meditate, good things begin to come to your life. When you begin to meditate, nice things will begin to come your way. Like many things which make people not happy and become sour and bite, you realize they are actually nothing, but because of lack of